According to engineer Christopher Mutiaba from the Uganda Electricity Transmission Company Limited, currently there is a nationwide power shortage of about 80 megawatts resulting from vandalism from Jinja Line. He says this resulted from vandalism of electricity installations. The latest incident is that of an unidentified man who was electrocuted to death while trying to cut the main transmission lines from Kira Dam.
What you see behind us is a collapsed structure. We also have a damaged one right ahead. About 3-4 years ago, we are in the same place and we are replacing 5 structures to get an extra 2. As I mentioned, it takes a lot. We in terms of outage, we have lost capacity of about 190 megawatts because each line carries about 95 at peak. And this is going to force us to load shed. We had no identification, but he had a phone.
Mutiaba further explains that it's very costly for them to replace the vandalized equipment. Currently, over 2 billion shillings is required to replace the vandalized power installations. He calls for tougher legislation against vandalism.
It's already costing us a lot, because by the time the star goes down, they have taken off like maybe 30% of the members, and they have kept replacing. A tower alone, if I'm right, a double circuit tower can be between 50,000 to 70,000. But when a damage like this occurs, you also need to replace on the foundation. The foundation is also equally expensive. And, cost-wise, as I explained, it's going to take us 2 billion.
Half of the capacity from own force, which is between 80 to 95 megawatts of power of non-supply. What this has meant is that our customers consuming up to 80 megawatts of power are currently undergoing load shedding at the moment to allow for restoration of this line. Just to assess the impact, we've, as Umeme, been forced to switch off our customers using the Namugongo substation, Waligo substation. We've switched off Kakiri substation. We've switched off the whole of the Bombo industrial load area to ensure that we can accommodate the 80 megawatts of power.
The locals have also condemned the act of vandalism.
General appeal again, as the minister emphasized on Thursday, is to watch out and ensure the public desist from vandalizing electric infrastructure, because the cost is much higher. Cost of non-supply of electricity, the cost of the equipment, each tower here costs more than $100,000 to be restored, and the general safety of the public. You can imagine all these wires that are lying down.
Currently, several areas have no power. Authorities say efforts are underway to restore connections. Story by Procopius Rumo for the news.